Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me? I am on a mission. I'm on a mission because every week I spend a lot of time answering email from people that say, Steve, I watched your videos on Evernote. I love the idea, but I'm stuck. I can't figure out the Evernote Web Clipper. You show the Evernote Web Clipper one way, but it works differently on my computer. And I am going to fix that right now. Fixing the stupid Evernote Web Clipper today on Dotto Tech. Okay, maybe I was overreacting just a little bit. It's not stupid. It's an awesome tool. The Evernote Web Clipper, if you don't know what it is this. You're looking at information online that you want to capture. You use the Evernote Web Clipper, which brings up this little dialog box that allows you to clip the article, a simplified article, the full page, the bookmark, or create a screenshot, which you can take a picture of the whatever content you want, and it saves it automatically into your Evernote account. I show this in many of my webinars, in all of my tutorials, I show people how to use the Evernote Web Clipper. And then people write me and say, Steve, I think that there's something wrong with my computer or me or you. And the issue is that I click on the Evernote Web Clipper and I don't get that. The problem is that you're not clicking on the Evernote Web Clipper when you have this problem. When you install the Evernote app on your computer, it installs in the tool in the menu bar here at the very top. It installs a little Evernote elephant. You see it right there? That's the elephant that people are clicking on. It's actually their operating system, and they get this, which looks nothing like the Evernote Web Clipper. It's simply a little tool for allow us to quickly create a note in Evernote. It's useful, but it's not the Web Clipper, and it drives me a little bit crazy. So that is what people are clicking on. You see there? This is where we want to click. Look in the web browser window. The Evernote Web Clipper installs in your browser as an extension, as an add-on into your browser. I'm in the Chrome browser here, and when I click on the Evernote icon here, up comes the Web Clipper. If you don't know how to install it, if you don't know what it is, let me show you how to install it. Let's go into Safari. If you're on the Mac, and in Safari and you don't have the Evernote Web Clipper, you can go into your Safari extensions, which basically launches a web page at Apple, which allows you to search for extensions. Let's do a quick search. We're going to type in Evernote Web Clipper. And it comes up with the Evernote Web Clipper here, which I can click on Install Now. And then it will install it as an extension. And now the Evernote Web Clipper, let's launch it in Safari. Oops, let's not watch a video. Let's watch it, launch it in Safari. Up it comes, just as it's supposed to. Shall we do it again? Yes, let's do it one more time. Let's install it in Firefox. Now in Firefox, you go to a slightly different place. You go under the Tools menu, and you click on Add-ons. When you go into the Add-ons, click on Extensions, and then do a search for Evernote Web Clipper again. Up it comes, and just click on Install. It then installs it. And then once Firefox restarts, we can launch the Evernote Web Clipper in Firefox. Now, one caveat about the Firefox install of the Evernote Web Clipper is it's more the old school one. It doesn't have the newer graphics that we are seeing in Safari and in Chrome, but it does the same things. It allows you to choose which notebook it's going to be clipped to. It allows you to choose different clipping styles. It just doesn't do quite as much, but still, most of the functionality is right here, and it's here in the browser. So I hope this alleviates some of the confusion. The bottom line is, don't go to your menu bar for the Evernote Web Clipper, even though you see the elephant there. Instead, go to the browser, the top of your browser, in the top of the browser bar, and that is where you go to clip to Evernote. And you will be happy, and I will be happy. I hope you found today's video to be useful. Oh, I hope you found it useful. There's three ways to stay in touch with us here in Dotto Tech. The first is subscribe to this channel. The second, subscribe to our newsletter and hear about all of our upcoming live events. Tons of webinars coming up here on Dotto Tech. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded site. It's supported through Patreon. If you want to know more about Patreon and what it's like to be a member of the Dotto Tech community, please click on our Patreon link and have a look. There are perks that are amazing attached to becoming part of our community. Till next time, I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.